Hey everyone, welcome. So in the previous video, we had set up blocking on our device. And in this video, I'll show you how you can set up a Grafana dashboard for your Blocky stats monitoring. As I had said in the previous video, Blocky by default does not have any web interface for stats monitoring. So if you want, or if you wanted to monitor your Blocky stats in the future, you would need a Grafana dashboard for it. There are two ways of installing Grafana on Debian. Either we can just directly download the package file and install it, and the other way is by installing the repository first. I'm going to take this route. There are two versions of Grafana. The first is enterprise, the other one is open source. You can use either, okay, it's fine for our needs. I'm just using the open source version, okay. I'm just pasting this one by one because you need one more package here, and that is gnu.pg. Okay, now we can install the key. Now let's install the repository. Okay, so let's see, sudo apt update first. You do have to do it after installing the repository, okay? Now sudo apt install Grafana. Okay, before starting our Grafana server, we have to open its config file. If you would want to use the ability to disable the Blocky from your Grafana dashboard directly, for that we have to do some settings here. To do that, let's sudo nano etc Grafana and grafana.ini. You have to open this config file, search disable sanitize, and this is the option, disable sanitize HTML. Okay, you have to make this true. Now save this config file, and now let's start the Blocky's service, okay? Okay, now let's see if our Grafana web page is working. And for that, open your web browser, type the IP address of your device. In my case, it's 180. Server. And the port number is 3000. Okay, the default username is admin. And the default password is also admin. Don't forget to change the Grafana's user password, okay? Now, for now, just leave this is here, okay? Because Grafana by default does not store any kind of data. It's only for data visualization. To store data, we are going to need a database application. Blocky uses a special kind of database for its stats storage, and that is called time series database, okay? For this, we are going to install Prometheus. So Prometheus, and this is my link. Let's just do wget. Okay, Prometheus has downloaded. Let me extract it. Okay, let me just move. If you want, you may want to move the folder because do something like Prometheus, okay? Because it would make it easier later for service install. So now let's open Prometheus folder. And now open this config file, nano Prometheus IML, okay? Now, a job name is Blocky and the our target is port 4000. Okay, if you have block keys running on some other device, you will just have to type that IP address here and followed by the port number, which is the default is 4000. Save this config file. Now let's start Prometheus to check if the target is our target is working. For Prometheus, the default port number is 9090, okay. Go to status, targets, and we have our endpoint up and running. Okay, so now we have our Prometheus. Prometheus also by default does not come with a service file, so it won't start with your device. Okay, I have made a basic service file. Let me copy this. So this service file would allow it to start on the boot. Okay, so let me do sudo nano etc systemd system. Let me name this service Prometheus dot service and paste it. For me, the path is okay. By default, block Prometheus only store data for 15 days, but if you want to extend that, you can just type the 30 days or 50 days or 60, 365, 1 year, 2 year, whatever you want, now according to your needs. I'm just using 30 days. Okay, then save this config file. Let's do daemon reload. Okay, so our Prometheus service is running. Now let's come back to Grafana. Let me just quickly refresh it. Okay, our 4000 endpoint is running. Okay, now go to data sources and on Grafana. Click on add. I already have, okay, I'll delete it to show you because this is from the previous test runs. I'll delete MySQL as well. And you have something like this. All you have to do is click on add data source, Prometheus, and type the, and you actually have to type it, okay? Don't just leave it blank. Okay, in my case, it's just localhost and followed the port on 9090, okay? 9090, and leave everything else at default, save and exit, okay? Now for the actual dashboard, do I have a link here? No, let me just quickly open the official link, okay, for Grafana dashboard for Blocky. Grafana. Yeah, this is the official dashboard. All you have to do is just copy this last number. Go back to block Grafana, go to plus and import, and just type this number here. Click on load. Our source is Prometheus default. You actually, okay, don't forget that you have to type the actual IP address here. Just don't type the local host here, okay? Even if you have Blocky and Prometheus running on the same devices, okay? Grafana, Prometheus, and Blocky, you actually have to type the IP address here. So the IP address in my case is 180, and the port number is 4000, okay? Click on import, and now with some time, okay, this dashboard would start populating. Okay, if you want to disable Blocky for some time, you now can just press off here and it would disable Blocky. Okay, let me restart it. So this part is done. Now you can monitor your Blocky stats with Grafana. Now let's take this a step further. Now let's say you want to actually monitor the queries, okay, how many queries are like on AdGuard. You can check how the top domain, okay, top most blocked domain and whatever else. Okay, so for that, you actually have to install another database server. Okay, I know this can be a bit too much, but what can I say? For that, now we are going to need a relational, okay, I was going to say rational relational database. Okay, to do that, go open your device, type in sudo apt install MariaDB server. Okay, okay, for now you won't be able to access MariaDB from your normal user. For that, we can add a new user to MariaDB. For now, only the root user can do that. So for that, yeah, sorry, you actually have to keep the MySQL running. Okay. Here you actually have to type the current user, okay, whatever user you are running, and you have to type it, then its name, then it, this is the password. For this demo, I'm just using the password for password, but just use something better, okay. Let's create a new user. Now new user is running. Let's now provide all the privileges to this user. Make sure to change this to from virtual to your actual username. Syntax error. Why there is a syntax error to virtual? Okay, at line 1. Oh yes, sorry. Actually, we have a syntax error here. Okay, now it's okay. Okay. And now let's flash privileges. Okay, now we can just log in to the user from here directly, or we can exit it. Now type MySQL, or you can type MariaDB, whatever you want. Okay, virtual p for that, password is password, and now we can log in with our normal user. Okay, for now let's create a database. In my case, the database name is Blocky. Okay, the database has been created, that's it, we can now exit it. Okay, now come to data sources, add data source. Come down, click on MySQL. The connection name is localhost.3306. The database name was Blocky, okay? And the user is virtual. And the password is, in my case, password, okay? I'm saving it, but it is working, but Blocky for now won't be sending any data to this database. Okay, for that you actually have to open the Blocky's config file. So let me come back, its name is config.yml. okay, come down. Uncomment the query log. The type is MySQL. The target is, what was the target? DB username. In my case, it's virtual. And the password is just password. TCP. The IP is just type the IP, or you can just type localhost here, okay? And database name was Blocky. Now come to log retention. You can increase the log retention to whatever you like. Okay, this, the other two stats are optional, or we are going to change that. So save your Blocky. Let me restart Blocky service. Okay, Blocky is now running. Now let's do journal CDL U Blocky service. Okay, Blocky is now sending the queries to the block to the database. Now again come to plus, import, for this, there is also another dashboard. Okay. Oh, my video is already here. Okay, Prometheus and Grafana. No, yeah, this is the one. Okay, then go to add. And this number is 14,980. Import it. Select the source. In my case, this is MySQL. Okay, it's showing this warning sign, but error sign. But don't worry, as we would browse the internet. Now I'm not using the blocky here. Okay, so I'll just type nslooker google.com 192.168.180.130. Give it some time, and yep, it is working. I did not even have to give anything. Okay, so yeah, my dear people, this is it. There are our queries. Okay, and as you would, these are our top 20 effective domains. These are query domains. It blocked by blacklist. It actually does not show the top blocked domains. Okay, so I'm sorry, I did not know that. I should have known that. Okay, so. Oh yes, I can also show you a bit of customization. Let's say, let me just open blocky dashboard. Let's say, just say it only displaying an IP address here, but you want to change it to some name. You can also do that. Just click on this down arrow, go to edit, come down here, click on add field override, field with names. Our name is 180. You have your IP addresses here. Click on add override property, and this is our, select this. Okay, we are going to override display name and change it to whatever your device's name is. For say I want to say hi YouTube, and it would change it to hi YouTube. Okay, click on apply and save the dashboard by someone else. Okay, don't worry about that. Last 3 hours, you can change the time here. Okay, I guess I'll see you in the next video, because now we have our Grafana dashboard running for stats monitoring and for queries as well. So there's no much, so there's nothing else to say here. Okay, so I guess I'll see you in the next video. Bye everyone.